Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Thursday, Feast of Saint Dominic. Our Mass presiders, Father Tito Caluag. Entrance antiphone. In the midst of the church, he opened his mouth, and the Lord filled him with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. May Saint Dominic come to the help of your church by his merits and teaching, O Lord. And may he who was an outstanding preacher of truth be a devoted intercessor on our behalf. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant I made with their fathers, the day I took them by the hand to lead them forth from the land of Egypt, for they broke my covenant, and I had to show myself their master, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will place my law within them, and write it upon their hearts. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer will they have need to teach their friends and relatives how to know the Lord. All from least to greatest shall know me, says the Lord, for I will forgive their evil doing and remember their sin no more. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your ways, and sinners shall return to you.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit. A heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Alleluia, alleluia. You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went into the region of Caesarea Philippi, and he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter said in reply, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus said to him in reply, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my heavenly Father. And so I say to you, you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of the netherworld shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Then he strictly ordered his disciples to tell no one that he was the Christ. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. "God forbid, Lord, No such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, Get behind me, Satan. You're an obstacle to me. You're thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, as we mentioned yesterday, you know, we'd like to reflect on our own faith journey. You know? Yesterday we had the Gospel of the Canaanite woman, you know, and then how the Lord praises her faith. You know? And here I think is a very important scripture passage for us to refine, or so to speak, to really understand and really make a person or the personal choices we need to make in order to live out our faith. No? So here really it is the personal faith and our assent, no, with regard to our personal faith. No? So the first point that I'd like to invite you to reflect on is that one is that the first question of the Lord, who do people say that I am? Then the second point for our reflection is the follow-up question, no? But really the main question, but you, who do you say that I am? No? And then the third and last point is the cause of discipleship. No? We see now here Christ giving us a prediction of the passion. No? So these three points. So first, no, it's important for us also to appreciate, no, just to add to our appreciation, this particular gospel passage was in Caesarea Philippi. No? And during that time, the Caesarea Philippi was like the place of the so-called world religions at that time. No? So that was the backdrop. No? That was the backdrop. So the Lord asking, who do you say, who do people say that I am? No? Because here you have all the, you might say, the world religions at that time. No? And so that was the first question. And if you notice, they did not answer correctly. No? And I think it's very important for us to appreciate that. No? That you know, in our faith journey, you know, people influence us in terms of who is God to us, what is our faith. You know, of course, you have parents, grandparents, teachers, for those who went to the Catholic schools, of course, the priests and the nuns or the parish priests. So there is an influence, or there are influences that help shape our faith, no? That help shape our relationship with Christ, no? But I think it's very dramatic that when the Lord asks them point blank, so to speak, no, they gave the wrong answers, no? And you know, these are wrong answers based on the tradition then, no? And then when they finally when the Lord changes, no, changes the question, but you, who do you say that I am? This is the second point, no? It's an invitation for us to reflect and realize that, you know, in our faith journey, we need to make a personal choice, no? And part of the deepening of our relationship with Christ is to make it a very personal relationship. That while we are grateful for everything that we have learned, no, everything that helps shape our faith, our religiosity and spirituality, we are very grateful for those. But then again, remember, our faith is a faith of freedom, no? And precisely the exercise of freedom begins by our choosing and really defining, no, our relationship with Christ based on our journey and our experience, based on our life story, if you wish, no? And to see how the movement of God in that life story calls us to mission, calls us to a certain vocation. So just to reflect on these first two points, no? To appreciate and be grateful for what people have given us in terms of our growth in faith, but also to realize that and to ask ourselves, have I made a choice, no, of who Christ is to us? No? And remember what we've reflected on over the years. No, part of our mission is defined by the quality of our relationship with God. So it's a very important, who do you say that I am? And there Peter answers correctly. No? So maybe just to think about these two things. No? And then the third and final point is and we will discuss this also again tomorrow, but the cost of discipleship. No? So Christ predicts his passion. No? And in the prediction of the passion, of course, Peter says, no, this cannot happen. No? It was very counter to what was then the prevailing thought, so to speak, of what the Messiah or who the Messiah is going to be. No? So here, if you notice, Peter objects, no, to the prediction of the passion and the resurrection. And then when he objects, there's a very important detail, no? And I think we mentioned this in previous masses, wherein the Lord said, "Get behind me, Satan." No? And of course, the point for reflection is that the cause of discipleship is that we must embrace the Paschal mystery, no? The passion and the cross and the resurrection. But the other thing I invite you to reflect on when the Lord said, "Get behind me, Satan," was that the Lord was telling Peter, you know, you need more formation. Because the whole image of that "get behind me, Satan," that is discipleship, remember. Discipleship is following Christ. And therefore, that in a sense, that comment of the Lord, "Get behind me," is that the Lord saying you need more formation. Follow me more to understand, you know, what it means to be my disciple. So siguro maganda, no, na itong napakaganda nitong ebanghelyon to sa pagpapalinaw ng ating pananampalataya. At bahagi ng pagpapalinaw ng pananampalataya ngayon ay pagpapalinaw ng ating pagiging mga disipulo ng Panginoon. Unang ang punto, di ba, tiyan ng Panginoon, ano ba ang sabi ng iba, sino ako? Kasi itong bahagi ito ng pagtubo natin sa ating pananampalataya. Na maraming taong nag-impluwensya at nagbuo ng ating pananampalataya. Simula sa magulang, sa pamilya, sa eskwelahan, sa parokya. At mahalaga yon, no? Mahalaga yon. Pero ang nakakagandang pagnilayan dito, nung tinanong ng Panginoon, mali lahat ng sagot. Ano? At para maging malinaw at siguro para matarok natin yung buod ng ating pananampalataya, binago ng Panginoon yung tanong. Ano? Pero kayo, sino ako sa inyo? Yun yung mahalagang tanong, di ba? Na bagaman tayo'y nagpapasalamat sa pagtubo natin, sa paghubog sa atin ng mga iba't iba nating impluensya, dadating ang panahon na kailangan nating mamili ng isang personal na ugnayan sa Panginoon. Ikaw, sino ako sa iyo? Yun yung mahalagang maabot natin, ano? Na punto ng ating paglalakbay sa ating pananampalataya. At siguro yung pangatlo at huling punto, yung palitan ng Panginoon at ni San Pedro sa huli, no? Tandaan natin, matapos itong usapan na ito, meron yung third prediction of the passion, no? At siyang tinutulan ni San Pedro, no? Sabi niya, hindi ako papayag. Pero ano yung sabi ng Panginoon? Bumalik ka sa likuran ko, Satanas, no? Kasi yun, nagpapahiwatig yun na kulang pa ang paghubog kay Pedro biging isang disipulo para maunawaan na walang pagsunod sa Panginoon, walang pagiging disipulo na hindi aakapin ang kanyang pagpapasakit, krus at muling pagkabuhay. So ito'y isang paalala, no, na patuloy ang ating paghubog bilang mga disipulo. At ang kahulugan ng pagiging disipulo ay sumunod sa Panginoon. Ano? Sumunod sa kanyang mga yapak. At iisa lamang ang daan, eh. Daan ng krus at muling pagkabuhay. So today let us pray, no, on this gospel, using this gospel, for us to also make our faith more personal. As we ponder on the foundations of the church, we pray with open hearts to God the Father for our own needs and the needs of the world.
That the Pope, the successor of St. Peter, may use the power of the keys wisely and according to God's plan. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the power of evil may not prevail over those who maintain positions of authority in the community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all believers may never lose sight of Christ as the cornerstone and foundation of their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We also continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, and pray that he may recover from his recent procedure. Let us pray also for all of his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. Let's also pray for the Dominicans as they celebrate, the Dominican family as they celebrate their feast day today. And let's continue to pray for those affected by the recent typhoon, Typhoon Karina, and the flooding. And let's also continue to pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Attend mercifully to the prayers we offer you, O Lord, by the intercession of Saint Dominic, and through the great power of this sacrifice, strengthen by the protection of your grace those who champion the faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Dominic you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions offered for our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata for peace.
God, our Heavenly Father, Lord of peace and justice, we humbly come before you during this time of escalating geopolitical tensions in our part of the world. Through the years, you have sustained our faith in you as a nation. It is our faith in your divine providence that has made us survive the countless natural and human-caused calamities that have come our way in our history as a people. Spare us, Lord, from the horrors of war. Hear our pleas as we cry out to you. Have mercy on us, Lord. Rescue us from the malevolent forces that influence world leaders. For we believe that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. We pray for our leaders entrusted with making crucial decisions for our nation. We place all our hopes in you, seeking your forgiveness and mercy for the times when our fears and suspicions have tainted our perceptions with ethnic biases and prejudices verging on racism. We earnestly pray, Lord, that you make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us bring love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us.
Saint Michael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Francis of Assisi,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us. And let us pray. May your church, O Lord, receive with wholehearted reverence the power of heavenly sacrament, of this heavenly sacrament, by which we have been nourished on the commemoration of Saint Dominic, and may your church, having flourished by means of his preaching, be helped through his intercession, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. And again, happy feast day to the Dominicans. And then also please join us for Proyecto Filipino tonight, premiering at 7. We're going to go on our last maybe 4-6 episodes, and then we're going to reformat. So we had a nice planning session. And today, this weekend, now we will continue to discuss some of the key points coming from the SONA. And then and from there, we will also we'll share with you the plans of how to reformat the program. No, so please join us for Proyecto Filipino, premiering at 7 p.m. tonight at the Conscience Collective channel. So maraming pong salamat and have a good day ahead.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.